Tracking the progress of your goals is key to achieving your goals. And using a spreadsheet is a really great way to do this. And it doesn't need to be complex. To track a goal in Excel, the first thing you need to do is, of course, create your goal. Now, this goal needs to be able to be quantified. That means that in some way, numbers need to be used to gauge the progress and the eventual completion of that goal. For example, if your goal is to network more, think about what that means. Maybe you set a goal of meeting people for coffee 4 times per month. Whatever it is, it just needs to be able to be quantified in some way. Once you've decided what your goal is, the next step is to enter its details into your Excel sheet. In this example, we're going to use Excel to help us track the progress being made on reaching a goal of saving $2,000 for emergencies. We'll lay out and enter the details of the goal in a way that we can track its progress throughout the year. We'll then create a chart that we can use as a quick visual of that progress. So for this example, I'm going to enter what the goal is, which is to save $2,000 for emergencies. I'm going to then create labels for savings goal, actual amount saved, percent completed. Then, right above those labels, I'm going to list the name of each month of the year. And then at the very end of that, I'll create another label for totals. Next, we'll create monthly targets. These are smaller goals that you'll meet each month, and by the end of the year, will total your bigger goal. This will also help you be able to tell if your bigger goal is realistic. So is this too ambitious or not ambitious enough? You will aim for what works best for you. And if you need to, you can always make any adjustments throughout the year. Under the total heading, sum the totals for all the months, and you can press Alt Equal on your keyboard for the auto sum shortcut. So then you'll copy this sum formula to the cell below it so that we can also sum the actual amount that we've saved. For percent completed, we'll need to enter a formula that divides the total amount that we've saved into the total savings goal, and then making sure to format this as a percentage. Then at the end of each month, we would enter the total amount that we saved that month. So here I'm just entering random numbers so we have something to work with for our chart. Creating a chart for your goal is a really great way to get a quick visual of the progress that you're making towards that goal. So for this example, we would need to chart the actual amount saved against the total savings goal. So to make the chart, using your cursor, select the labels for the fields that we're tracking, which again, savings goal and actual amount saved, and make sure to select them both together, not by clicking on each one individually. Then holding down the control key on your keyboard, do the same for the totals. So select both your totals, selecting them together, not by clicking each one individually, and then we'll insert a chart. So we'll need to go to the Insert tab in the Chart section. We'll click on Recommended Charts, select the chart, and click OK. And if you want to give your chart a little bit of pizzazz, you can select one of the chart styles that are available for you. And that's it. You've now created a simple goal tracker in Excel to help you keep up with your goals. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.